James, game 1,225 on the NHL schedule. The Pens vie to clinch the Eastern Conference. Philadelphia tries to spoil that celebration and avoid Pittsburgh in round one. The starting goaltenders are brought to you by Tim Hortons. Proud to support Timbits Minor Hockey, where the first goal is having fun. There's Marc-Andre Fleury, red hot, eight straight wins. And since coming back from injury, a 947 save percentage. Marty Biron making his 18th start from the last 20 for Philadelphia. In his last tune-up for his first ever Stanley Cup playoff game. There's Glenn Healy between the benches. Heals the eighth matchup. And if it's anything like last Wednesday, we'll get a little preview of the playoffs.
I think there's some importance to the game. Not necessarily who you play in the playoffs, who you don't have to play. And that's got to be Philadelphia's thinking today. Don't play Pittsburgh round one.
They start with Jeff Carter, Scotty Upshaw, Mike Knubel for Philadelphia. Upshaw with a huge goal on Friday night that really clinched the victory over New Jersey that nailed down the playoff spot for Philadelphia. Back comes Marian Hossa once again in this game without the man he was acquired to play with, Sidney Crosby. And he'll start with Staal and Talbot. Here's Maxim Talbot playing it behind the net. Jordan Staal in Crosby's spot to start this game. Knubel after it on the far side. Gets a check in. Orpik throws it wide of the net. There's Ryan Whitney sending it deep. Lassie Kukkonen on Talbot. It goes to Hossa. Quickly Carter closes on him. A Staal shot goes weak and wide. And now Marian Hossa back on it. Sending it across. And that one deflecting off the glass. And it comes out to center ice. Both teams changing as Ryan Whitney off Staal deep. Talbot in on the forecheck as his line mates are changing behind him. There's Peter Sikora on the ice and a sharp angle shot by Malkin. Stopped on the short side by Biron. Evgeny Malkin starts the day 6 points back of Alex Ovechkin. Is there still an Art Ross Trophy race to be decided? Malkin has joked that three goals, which would give him 50 and three assists, is doable today.
Hey, you know, I've got Tinkerbell up in the booth above me there, Chris Cuthbert. You believe it's possible as well.
Well,
you've been barking about it all day, 6 points, haven't you?
I'm not saying it's impossible.
And while we're on that topic, Gonchar needs five to catch Lidstrom. So is that possible?
I'm not holding my breath on
okay,
that one.
Okay, there we go.
Letang and Hal Gill sending it ahead. It's off Ryan Malone into the Philly zone. And both teams will make changes. Kimmo Tiiminen behind the net for the Flyers. Named today as the top Philadelphia defenseman for this season. Winner of the Barry Ashby Award. Braden Coburg ahead. And that's an offside at the Pittsburgh line.
Well, Chris, an enormous game. Lots of pressure. Pittsburgh wants to clinch the East. Let's take a look at the other night before the game. Talbot and Fleury really have something going. He's not a head case like most goaltenders that I know. And here is today. Same thing. Huge game. And the two of them seem to have a little bit of chemistry. They like to joke around. And that is every game. And before puck drop, the last guy to talk to Fleury is Talbot. So, yes, it's a big game. But you can't tell me that Fleury's not too worked up about it. Just business as usual.
Whatever he has been doing of late, he's got to keep doing because he's been red hot for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Red hot after his injury. And that's somewhat surprising. One game over 500 before their injury, nine over after the injury. Could it just be all the new gear? Because he switched his equipment.
Chris Beach in the lineup is centering a line with Pascal Dupuy and Jarkko Ruutu. Beach coming off an injury for his first game in quite some time. And we're looking forward to seeing Gary Roberts back in the lineup for the first time since late December. But here's Beach throwing it cross crease. Played up back in behind the net. Jarkko Ruutu will get some attention today after the knee-on-knee hit that has knocked Daniel Briere out of this game, as was the case on Friday in the 3-0 victory over New Jersey. Here's Sergei Gonchar, second in defense scoring on the year. He sends it ahead. After it goes Adam Hall, back after a lengthy injury himself. And Gary Roberts on the ice. First time since December 29th. The Penguins veteran assistant captain wearing number 10. Braden Coburn, what a fine year he's had. First full year with Philadelphia, coming over in the deal from Atlanta last year. Coburn with the puck. And he takes it back again. Coburn on the right wing. That goes off Steve Downey, fencing in front of the Pittsburgh bench. And play is whistled down. We've got an update.
Welcome back, Gary Roberts. Missed 3 months. Had a pretty good first shift. Less is more until the end of the shift when he tried to stick his butt end and down his face. And so Gary will get on the score sheet right away. Not with a goal and assist, but with a penalty. Been a pretty quiet start to the game though, Chris.
Not at all like Wednesday night. The number two ranked power play in the National Hockey League. The Philadelphia Flyers go to work. Flyers with 84 power play goals. And if you want to nitpick about the Penguins, really the first area of concern heading to the playoffs, Glenn would be their penalty killing, ranked 23rd.
27th on the road, and that is troublesome. That's why it's so important to get home ice all the way through the East. And that 27th doesn't look so bad because you're playing at home.
Jeff Carter's on it, couldn't hook up with Knubel. On the near side, Joffrey Lupul off the boards, checked by Gonchar. Talbot ahead, and here's Dupuis. And Talbot tried to hold up, but he was a step ahead of the play, offside.
One area the Flyers have really gotten better at has been their power play. You mentioned it, Chris, second on the power play last season. They were 27th. And because of that 27th, well, I had a worse number. They were 30th in the NHL with regards to success. They were the worst team in the league. And it's a lot of the players that Paul Holmgren acquired that have really made a difference. Briere has really made a difference on their power play. Timo Tiiminen, who won top defenseman, the Barry Ashby Award tonight for the Philadelphia Flyers, big impact player. All the players Holmgren has acquired, they've all had huge impacts on the success of the team immediately.
Well, like the Montreal Canadiens, the leaders in power play, they do it by committee. There's a shot, Fleury's got it. With Scott Hartnell on the doorstep, a menace on Wednesday, and a questionable starter for this game, suffering from the flu.
I like Fleury's positioning here. He used to chase the game early on in his career. Quiet feet, quiet hands, very poised, not chasing the game, not racing out at a puck that's at the point, but deep in his net, and he makes the save, controls the rebound.
10-1-1 with a 1.57 goals against average. It's coming back off the high ankle sprain, centering pass, knocked away, and Gonchar clears it with 20 seconds left in the Roberts penalty. We'll get into it as the game goes on, Glenn, but both these teams with goaltenders that don't have much. Well, Biron with no playoff experience, and Marc-Andre Fleury with just one postseason win in Stanley Cup play. At the side of the net, Fleury down, got a stick on it, and Malone will clear as Roberts returns.
Well, the only one with any real playoff savvy and swagger would be Brodeur. That about 164 games in the playoffs.
Here's Peter Sikora picking off a pass, and his shot went off Kukkonen wide of the net. Malkin on it, he takes a hit. Penalty coming up against Philadelphia. Funny hop off the boards, and it's frozen by Biron. When we come back, the Pittsburgh Penguins will be on the power play.
Marty Biron gets a high-sticking penalty, but before we look at the penalty, let's take a look at the war between Hartnell and Gonchar. There's some flashbacks to the last game. Gonchar gives him a little butt end in the face, not too bad, and the war continues tonight. A lot of the battle zones in front of the net. Watch the smart play of Gonchar. He fronts Hartnell and backs him basically into the goaltender, who's totally ineffective, and then takes the pass away. And here's the penalty right here. That little hook. Two or less for Biron.
Number two power play in the league of Philadelphia generated one shot. Now the number three power play in the NHL goes to work. Flyers get it out. Here's Mike Richards on it. Richards into the zone. And play stopped.
One of the reasons,
on the offside.
One of the reasons I think Flyers don't want to play the Pittsburgh Penguins, you know, there's this mystique here in Philadelphia, the Broad Street Bullies, that tough style, the blue-collar crowd, blue-collar team will take it in the trenches. And if you take penalties, then what's going to end up happening is you're going to end up sending Pittsburgh to the power play. Their power play, too creative, too many looks, far too dangerous.
Yes, Exhibit A was last Wednesday. Four power play goals. Crosby with a couple of them. Three power play points. Malkin dangerous as well. And he'll get things organized. And the boos normally reserved for 87 are being directed at 71 so far here in Philadelphia, where the Penguins always get a warm reception. Here, Jeff Carter bursting out. Carter with Knubel going to the net. Shot blocked by Ryan Whitney. Carter's going to get it again. And Philly looks more dangerous on this Pittsburgh power play. Centered, and Carter tied up by Ryan Whitney on the pass from Mike Knubel. Under a minute left in the first Pittsburgh power play. Here's Whitney walking in. Sikora, weak shot, wide of the net. It'll come around to Whitney at the point. He's been struggling of late offensively. No goals in his last 18 for a offensively gifted Pittsburgh defenseman. Big 19 sends it across. Gonchar back to Whitney. Malkin awaits, doesn't get the pass. Picked off, away goes R.J. Umberger. And his shot stopped by Fleury. Umberger, the Pittsburgh area native who has scorched his hometown team for six goals already this season. And he only has 13 for the year. Nothing doing on Pittsburgh's first power play. And just 10 seconds remaining. Fleury out of the net. Stall on him quickly. Puck cleared to the line, but kept in by Letang. Jolted by Richards. Kukkonen will swing it around. Knocked down by Hossa. Out of the box comes Downey, serving the penalty. He knocked down Letang. Away goes Richards. It's a three-on-one. Across it goes. Back Richards. And he missed on the redirect. Crashing into Fleury. And he's going to get a penalty for it. So the Flyers miss a chance to get the icebreaker. And they'll be right back into the penalty box. And Richards having words with referee Paul Dvorsky, who made the call.
Crowd not happy. Flyers not happy. All this happened right out of the penalty box. Pittsburgh has given up now three odd man rushes and two shifts. Right out of the box, there's the hit. Downey in the box for a Baron penalty. And then there's the jump on Fleury that causes Richards to go to the box. You know, sometimes when you get a penalty to your goaltender, you really wonder why they use fourth line guys. You know, whether it's a Cote or Downey to kill the 2 minutes while they sit in the penalty box. Why not use a skilled guy that doesn't kill penalties? So if that happens again, you do officially get a solid 3-on-1.
Boy, this power play undone again as Knubel comes in, knocked down by Gonchar. The fans outraged now as play continues. Peter Sikora to the line, drops for Malkin. Malkin sends it across for Whitney now as Malkin took a hit. Has it in the corner, working against Kukkonen, who came up with it. Gonchar at the line. Gonchar shot. And that's deflected wide of the net. Gonchar second in power play points this year. Only Kovalev with more. And another pass picked off. Knubel will roll it down the ice. First power play for Pittsburgh, Glenn. No shots. Philadelphia had three. A couple of scoring chances, and they've looked more dangerous on this second one as well.
Well, and you know, that's one of the reasons why I don't like the fact that Crosby's not playing. You know, don't change gears at all. You keep your foot right down on the accelerator and keep this ball rolling for Pittsburgh. Don't create sloppy, lousy garbage habits. And that's what I've seen so far from Pittsburgh through 10 minutes.
Brooks Orpik sending it in. 50 seconds of power play time remaining. Umberger knocked it down. Tiemannen unable to clear. Hossa there. Arian Hossa looking for goal number 300. Sitting on 299 and 29 for the season, looking for his 830 goal campaign. Plays it back to the point. Letang across. Orpik. He's being bothered there by Jimmy Dowd. Roberts behind the net. Looking for Hossa up top. Hossa with a move on Umberger. There's a shot. Skull, a hot shot. And not sure if Baron got a glove on it, or maybe that glanced off the crossbar. It goes out of play.
Another good ad for the Philadelphia Flyers has been Jimmy Dowd. Now watch the angle he takes here on Orpik. Inside out. And that leaves Baron the ability to see over his right shoulder. Any shot goes to the glove. And he's able to make the easy save. So Flyers, you know, a lot of bravado about some of the bigger names that they added to the lineup, but a guy like Jimmy Dowd, who's so good on faceoff, so good as a penalty killer, and knows how to play without the puck, obviously, with his dreadful, boring time in New Jersey and in Minnesota, but he's got it figured out and doesn't have to drink the Kool-Aid.
39 years of age, penalty over. Here's a pass in front, big stop. Marty Barra, Jarkko Ruutu on the doorstep, and now Thorsson back. There's Richards out of the box to the attack, knocked down by Letang. Another reaction from the fans as Fleury clubs down the loophole shot, and Hal Gill and Richards have words behind the net. Now it's starting to heat up here in Philadelphia. Still scoreless, the Penguins and the Flyers.
Quiet start to the hockey game this afternoon. Marty Barra's only had to make three saves. Three saves don't really account for the 10 bellers like this. Ruutu with an excellent chance. The best of the game. Now, we need a little hate in this game. We've got to enjoy the violence a little bit more. And it is starting to heat up a little bit now as Richards tries to make his way to the front of the net.
Flyers MVP for the season, Mike Richards. And since he returned from a torn hamstring, Flyers 6-3-1 en route to the playoffs after a 56-point season a year ago in which they were dead last. Here's Hossa over the line. Stahl looking for some room on the other side. Knubel's there. And now Upshaw turns with it. Scotty Upshaw, who did not play on Wednesday, a healthy scratch, but again made a big impact Friday in the playoff clinching win over New Jersey. Knubel wraps it back in deep. After it, there is Carter. Upshaw cruising in there. And he belted Gill, who goes after Upshaw. There's the hate and a penalty upcoming against Hal Gill and the Penguins. Flyer power play when we come back, but first, an update with Jay Onright.
Roughing penalty for Hal Gill. This all starts behind the net. Hal Gill doesn't have the foot speed to get to that puck, and Scotty Upshaw runs him over. Gill takes exception to it with the left jab to the jaw that leads to a roughing penalty.
Hartnell Prospel up front. Timo Tiimonen, Umberger, the other forward on the power play for Philadelphia. 0-for-1, a centering pass for Prospel broke it up. Talbot gets it across, and Dupuis with speed. Richards trying to cut him off with the pass. Dupuis sends it wide of the net, and Hartnell back to collect in his own zone. Lloyd Minster, Scott Hartnell across. Umberger broke it up, and the penalty killers have had the best of the power play units so far in this opening period.
Now you think about the Flyers, they're trying to get it done without their top PP guy in Briere. And likewise, Penguins are trying to get it done without one of the best PP guys in the world in Crosby.
There's Knubel in the corner, and now Prospel out. Umberger a shot, and Fleury's got that.
It's another example of Fleury having patience, poise, and not chasing the game. Get set on a good solid position just outside the blue paint. Keeps his feet quiet, keeps his hands quiet, and looks big in the net, and makes what is an easy save to control the rebound. I think that's been the evolution in Fleury's game. When he's not on his game, he's chasing it. Ends up in the corner, he's on his back, he's doing the two-pad stack, but he looks confident, poised, and big in the net to me.
Again, the power play is struggling as Randy Jones goes back with a half minute remaining in the Hal Gill roughing penalty. Jones ahead. Braden Coburn will pound it in. Jeff Carter on it. He was tied up by Talbot. Dupuis tried to redirect, but it's held in. Coburn Jones in a shot goes wide of the net. Upshaw looking for Joffrey Lupul. Lupul working against Orpik. Now Upshaw. Lupul, Carter in front, and Gonchar interceded. And Gonchar after it now with Gilt out of the penalty box. Rink wide it goes. Al Gill goes to the net, and Duran steered the shot away. Jeff Carter starts back, and he'll just flip it from his own side of center. That's an icing call against Philadelphia. Still scoreless. It's the NHL on TSN from Philadelphia. The first period brought to you by Chevrolet. Hockey brings Canadians together. Chevrolet brings Canadians to hockey. Share your hockey stories at letsgochevrolet.ca.
Fans very disappointed that Crosby not in the lineup tonight. And they came, with some beautiful signs. Some absolute wonderful pieces of art. Yes, diver, flounder, loser. He's even pointing to it. Almost like he knew we were there.
You always enjoyed the warmth and hospitality here at the Wachovia Center.
And for all of Canada, yes, Malkin still six behind Ovechkin. Chris.
And counting.
So,
yes, it doesn't look like one of those shootout games here in Philadelphia, does it?
No.
Only six shots for Philly and four for Pittsburgh here in the opening 15 minutes or so, and we're still scoreless.
Pittsburgh probably looks at it from the standpoint, do we want to play Ottawa or do we want to play Philadelphia? And Ottawa, with their injuries, particularly to Alfredson, who we hear from the grapevine that it's more serious than originally thought, you know, they might be the team that they want to play versus this Philadelphia Flyer team that are a tough team to play at home.
And do the Flyers want Washington or Pittsburgh, or do players even think about it once they drop the puck?
Well, I think that if it was me playing in that Philadelphia sweater, I would definitely not want to play the Pittsburgh Penguins. They're a team that has been built to be deep and to go deep in the playoffs. You know, you think about Pittsburgh, they lost Fleury for 28 games. Their starting goalie, didn't matter. Conklin had an MVP-type season. They lost their star player in Crosby. Oh, it's trouble. 28 games without Crosby. They actually have a better winning percentage without him than with him. And then you go down the list of guys like Talbot, Roberts. They've had a long list of injuries that are closing in on almost 300 man games, and yet they haven't lost a beat and could win the East with a win today.
There's Marian Hossa on his backhand, tried to play it back to the point into the skates of Lupul and set out. It is an unbelievable stat, but without Sidney Crosby, the winning percentage for Pittsburgh 642 with 87 in the lineup, the winning percentage 621. Centering pass, Stahl had to take it off his skate, and by then he couldn't get the shot away. Now Roberts scoops it back to Hossa. Roberts playing with Stahl. And Hossa, as he returns to the Pittsburgh lineup. Gary Roberts just left it there. Thorsson. And now Philadelphia gets control and work it ahead. Here's Richards. Over the line, Mike Richards sends it across. There's the former Oiler Thorsson. Pass picked off, and Ruutu starts back. With Hossa, who's at the end of a shift. Hossa holds and now plays it wide of the goal. Talbot off the bench into the fray against R.J. Umberger, working along the wall. Talbot in support. Umberger knocked it away, but Ruutu back on it. Ruutu off the boards and then had it knocked off his stick. And it's played into the Pittsburgh zone. Hartnell behind the net. There's Denny Prostel. Prostel swings it back. Hartnell, one away from a career best matching 25th goal. Umberger does some fencing there with Talbot. Now Whitney looks ahead. Talbot redirects deep and heads to the bench on a change. Ryan Parent plays it around. A lead feed from Knubel to Upshaw. Scotty Upshaw one hands it in and then runs into Gill. And Gill takes him down hard. Second time those two have hooked up. They've had something going in the first period. Upshaw's got it. Playing it behind the net. Knubel after it, but Letang wins that battle. Chris Letang outlets. Ryan Malone to work. Kimmo Timonen watching him. And now Braden Coburn. Off the boards ahead, Knubel. He'll scoop it in and turn back on a Philadelphia change. Here comes Brooks Orpik. Talbot over the line. Peter Sikora shot. That's knocked down en route. Dashing back is Thorsson. Thorsson's played well in recent games for Philly. Turns it over inside the line. Beached, taken down by Richards. And Yaroslav Modrý back in his own zone. Less than two to play here in the opening period. Still scoreless. Philadelphia with six shots. Pittsburgh with four. There's a pass at center, scooped up by Staal. Penguins got back onside to allow Staal to work against Modrý. Staal hit there by Richards, still maintains possession. George Larocque from the corner. And he hears it from the fans. Richards knocked down, or Modrý knocked down Robert. Staal's got it. Watched by Richards. Gonchar across. Brooks Orpik a shot, and that was blocked. Modrý got in the way of that, but the Flyers can't get it out. Larocque along the boards. Now Lupul will finally get a chance to skate it out, get to the red line. Unable to get it deep, however, and that is really belted in front of the Pittsburgh bench by Gonchar, and that will draw a crowd and a response.
Philadelphia, they got about nine guys on the ice. So if I'm them, I wouldn't get involved in this altercation.
You're right. They 2-4. 6-7 as Richards now makes his way off.
I guess if George is on the ice, you have to play with seven just to make it even if you want to get involved in the fisticuffs. There's the dump in, there's the play, and Gonchar known for putting points on the board, but boy, he's been a real pain in the rear end for the Philadelphia Flyers. And here comes the Orange Cavalry, seven of them strong.
Well, people in Philadelphia feel he should be a finalist for the Norris Trophy, Sergei Gonchar. He has not been a top three pick among the Blue Liners in his NHL career. Look at the traffic here.
Seven guys. And here they come.
Yes, the Magnificent Seven.
Yep.
Well, there was a delayed penalty that allows them six with Marty Biron going to the bench, but...
And they are now sending Downey over to the box. So looks to me like they're going to get it too many men on the ice. Four on four hockey.
So is indeed too many men.
Yep.
Well, that somebody just came out on a change after the whistle, but not the case.
Okay, now last penalty. It ends. Puck gets turned over. Downey steps on the ice. Three on one. Put someone in the box with some skill. Doesn't play four on four.
Malone and Malkin in this four-on-four situation against Carter and Upshaw in the final minute of this first period.
Offside, offside!
Puck played in deep, and Coburn back to get it. Here's Upshaw. 20 seconds left in the period. Rob Scuderi after it for Pittsburgh. Took a jolt from Upshaw. Ryan Whitney ahead, and here comes one last dash in the period for the Penguins, but it's offside. 10.3 seconds left on the clock
still
in the opening period.
Still six back, Chris, and if we've got effort like this, he's going to stay six back. You can really see it from ice level. There are certain players that, you know the game is important because it matters to them. Upshaw's had a great first period, but there's also some other players, and maybe the message is sent when you sit Crosby out. You know, the game doesn't really mean that much. You were sitting out our captain and our star player.
15 points for Malkin in the first seven against Philadelphia. You're right, he has not looked like he's going to add to the totals so far this afternoon. Nothing to report after 20 minutes. We are scoreless in Philadelphia. Let's join James Duthie. Who we got here?
Chris, your 403 wake-up call. Pittsburgh sloppy. This is not the type of game that we're accustomed to seeing. That team that won and could win the East. Too many turnovers. Here's the only hit. The only hit of the period by the Pittsburgh Penguins. 7-1 were the hits. And Pittsburgh have got to get their game going.
No, they didn't look like Eastern Conference champions. And again, a win today will move them into a tie, and they get the tiebreaker against Montreal. Power play had nothing going on. Number 71 didn't look like he is en route to a six-point game, as he had just one shot. R.J. Umberger, by the way, of the Flyers, had three of the six Philadelphia shots. And maybe Michael Therrien set the tone with the pregame scratch of Sidney Crosby.
Yeah, I think that had a big factor. You know, you send a message to everybody. And granted, you might be happy with one day's rest for a guy, and it gives him a full week off. But I'm not a huge fan. I think talking to some of the Penguin players, they weren't huge fans also, the fact that Crosby would be sat down. One that surprises me, though, is Darryl Sedor. That's the player that I find surprisingly out of the lineup. A veteran who's got the playoff swagger, has got a Stanley Cup, knows what it takes to win. There's a guy that you've relied on through the whole year. The guy that I'd have in my lineup.
Didn't play Wednesday either. Here's Jeff Carter into the big stop by Fleury with the pad as Carter was allowed to dash in. Then he hooks down Letang, and a penalty coming up against the Flyers center, who came close to scoring and now will put Pittsburgh on the power play.
Sloppy start again for the Pittsburgh Penguins, and a huge save by Fleury. Play in front of the net. This is basically a 2-on-0. Fleury stays deep in his net, is able to get across, makes the first save, and controls the rebound with the right pad.
Jeff Carter looking for number 30, would be his first 30-goal campaign. Instead, he's off, and for 22 seconds, it's four skaters against three on this Pittsburgh power play. Malkin and Hossa with Stahl, three forwards, and Ryan Whitney. Marian Hossa back to Whitney. Richards up front for Philadelphia. Centering pass, a big stop by Biron off Stahl in the slot. Held in by Malkin. 5 seconds left, 4-on-3. Malkin a shot and off the locker of Biron. Hossa's got it. Now Downey and Gonchar back. Gonchar will move to the left point. Downey in a penalty-killing role that he probably wouldn't have if he wasn't serving the penalty glove.
Boy, someone might have mentioned that.
So defensive responsibility, offensive opportunities if you put a different guy in the penalty box.
That's right, and you better be Cindy Clawson now and get off.
And he does. Pittsburgh power play has not threatened yet. Maybe here, Stahl bursting through. Unable to get a shot away as Kiemann held it up at the last second. And it will be sent back down the ice by Jimmy Dowd. 50 seconds left in the Carter penalty. And here is Gonchar. Played back for Gonchar again. His shot in traffic. And Biron picks it off with Chris Beach on the doorstep. Well, TSN's coverage of the NHL postseason begins tomorrow night. 3 hours of preview shows, including McGuire's Monsters, the TSN Fantasy Draft Special, an hour and a half Stanley Cup Playoff Preview Special, and exclusive live coverage of the Scotiabank NHL Draft Lottery. Coverage begins at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific in Guelph. We call that the Drew Doughty Sweepstakes, Glenn.
You think he's going second or first?
They depend on the team that gets the lottery pick.
Well, the LA Kings, they potentially have interviewed him now 80 times, so I think they have some interest.
Well, they may have moved in by now, but no doubt.
What can they ask him?
In all likelihood, it will be the Steven Stamkos sweepstakes, and Stamkos with a pair of goals last night in a playoff game against Kitchener. But here's Lupul with a shot. Gonchar got a stick on that, and it deflects up onto the netting.
Well, everyone gets a turn on the power play for Pittsburgh. Beach is getting a turn here, but the schooling is done by Dowd. Pushes the stick back to Beach and then wins the draw clean. Certainly something that Philadelphia Flyers love to have in their lineup. A guy like Dowd who can kill penalties, win big faceoffs, That last power play for the Pittsburgh Penguins, Gary Roberts, who hasn't played in 3 months, and Beach on the power play. So I guess it's everybody gets a turn here today.
Apparently the sole focus is not the Eastern Conference crown. Adam Hall's on the ice now with Ruutu and Talbot. And Gill will play it back. Skip past Letang. Pittsburgh trying to get control. There's Ruutu reaching for it. And he'll just give it away. Nobody wants the puck. Knubel's got it to Prospel. Couldn't center against Letang. With Vinny Prospel, the Flyers have 7 men in their lineup with at least 20 goals. That's tops in the NHL. Knubel's going to get a penalty for a hit on Ruutu and going back at him again. And Mike Knubel will give Pittsburgh yet another power play opportunity.
Started off as a bad shift for Ruutu. He turned the puck over twice in a row on the same shift. And when you're a fourth line energy guy and you do this, you're probably going to be a fifth line lack of energy guy. Twice in the same shift. There's the battle in front of the net. And here's the penalty. Knubel cross checks him from behind. So Ruutu does draw a penalty, which is good news for Pittsburgh. Well, you had mentioned, Chris, the Philadelphia Flyers. You said 7 20-plus goal scorers. Last year they had 2. So a dramatic improvement for their hockey club in the goal-scoring area.
And one of those two was Simone Gagné, who has been injured most of the season. So to do that without really their top offensive threat, what a credit to the way they've bounced back this year. Here's Gonchar, a shot. Biron's got the stop, trying to smother it, and does get a whistle. Even though that puck, according to Marian Hossa, was never frozen.
Watch the skill level of Gonchar here. You can never skate as fast as you can pass the puck. Gonchar gets the puck and immediately throws it 100 feet across the ice. That opens up the box. Then with his head up, shot that is deflected by Malone and nearly ends up in the back of the net. But it's Gonchar that creates the play. He holds onto that puck at the right point. Gets to 4 Mississippi. The box gets set up for Philadelphia.
46 power play points for Sergei Gonchar. Again, Kovalev with 47. The NHL leader. Across it comes. That skipped over the stick of Whitney. Chance to clear. Kukkonen off the boards. Maybe a 2-on-1. Richards and Lupul. Malkin trying to get back. A pass for Lupul, and he sent it cross crease. Gonchar will hit up ice. How many chances have Philadelphia had shorthanded in this game? At least more than Pittsburgh's generated on their power play, to be sure.
No, Pittsburgh is not sharp. And, you know, part of the reason for the chances, you put Malkin on the point at times, and that's created some of the odd man rushes in the first period. But this odd man rush is broken up by a solid defensive play by 55 Gonchar. There have been at least 6 scoring chances created while Philadelphia's been shorthanded. Now, they're good at it. Not that good.
Shots are even when Pittsburgh's on the power play. They have 3, and the Flyer penalty killers have 3. Shots even in the game at a very quiet 8 apiece.
And the other side of the intensity level, Chris, is if this is the first round matchup, you want to plant a seed of doubt in Philadelphia's head. You don't want them to believe that they can beat you. Because if Philadelphia does win today, that would be 5 wins on the season out of 8. Against the best team in the East.
I guess the flip side, after the intensity of Wednesday night, you wonder if they're just saving it for the postseason if they have to go against each other. That puck out of play, just 25 seconds left in the Knubel penalty.
Potentially that could be it. Don't want to get hurt. Want to be healthy going into the postseason. Pittsburgh believes they can go deep, they can go long. They've got all the pieces of the puzzle. They've withstood all kinds of adversity through the year, and they believe they're much more of a school group than last year. And had the early exit from the postseason. 2 goaltenders, lots of defense, multiple pronged scoring attack.
Ryan Malone knocks it down at center, comes back in. Last call on this 4th Pittsburgh power play. That's 0 for today. Malkin sends it across to Malone. Redirected wide of the net. Out of the box comes Knubel, held in by Orpik. And that's a glove pass from Orpik to Sikora. Well, closed captioning of the NHL on TSN is brought to you by the 2008 Kia Rondo, Canada's urban utility vehicle. From Kia, the power to surprise. So the team back at full strength. Hartnell, Prospel, and Umberger for Philadelphia. Jericho Ruutu on a line with Hossip and Jordan Staal. There's Ryan Parent playing it off the boards inside the Pittsburgh line. Ruutu scoops it ahead. Hossa unable to come up with it. And Parent back to get it. Parent taking the spot to Jason Smith on the Philadelphia back line. And for this game, four members of the Philadelphia blue line without any Stanley Cup playoff experience. Of course, Jason Smith has plenty on that run to the Stanley Cup final a couple of years back with Edmonton. Orpik back to touch. And an icing call, 6 minutes 24 seconds into the second. Thank you, Jay. Hey, Glenn, met an old friend today.
Yeah, the biggest idiot in the building. And when I played here and I sat on the bench, he would yell at me all game long to the point where I took Vaseline, covered the entire glass so we couldn't see the game anymore. And then told him, you keep it up, you're going to have this all game. Now he got it cleaned in between periods, did it again. Once again, reapplied the Vaseline. And he got tired of not being able to watch the game through a blurred film. Anyways, we had a nice little chat today.
But time heals all wounds.
He said, remember me? Oh, yeah. How could I forget you?
Oh, one of the many characters here in Philadelphia. And that guy was dealing with one of the characters in the NHL, to be sure, Mr. Healy.
The only place in the world where the fans will jump in the penalty box when Ty Domi's in there. Can you say stupid?
Well, it has been a quiet game. It might get a little loud here. Jim Dowd's on the ice with Riley Cote and Steve Downey. And here's Cote, the Winnipeg native, who had quite a tilt Wednesday night with George Larocque. And after the game, Larocque called him pound for pound his toughest adversary in the league. Here comes Malkin, dropping it for Sikora. They've been reunited. Cross ice for Malkin, dumps to the corner. Malone and Sikora there. They can't get untracked. And it's rolled back down the ice. Orpik back to get it. Gonchar outlets left side past Sikora. There's Braden Coburn back to get it. Timo Timonen. Carter on the left side. Upshaw drops. Coburn fires. And Fleury stops it. The rebound came loose. And it's just played wide. Close call there as Knubel had a chance. Fleury thought he had it frozen. Malkin slowly ahead. Now Gonchar to Orpik to the red line. He'll dump it deep. Pittsburgh changing. Yaroslav Modry off the glass and out. 8.5 minutes into the second period. Still awaiting the game's first goal. Jordan Staal shot it wide. Staal looking dangerous on that attack as he centered Gary Roberts and Marian Hossa. Hossa bending off Modry. Holds. Lost it. Richards up with it. And Hossa trying to get it back. Shoulders with Thorsson. Richards there, Roberts on him. And now Timo Timonen to Lupul. Joffrey Lupul just missed springing Thorsson, who had a lane to the net. Both teams changing as Modry back. Yaroslav Modry acquired from Los Angeles at a deal. He is actually the Kings nominee for the Masterton Trophy. And that's an offside at the Philadelphia line.
Well, they didn't have a better pick, so they let him go to the Flyers. That being said, the best chance of the hockey game, 22, Knubel. Watch this Good thing that Mike doesn't have a bonus for 29 goals, because he won't sleep at night for missing that one. Puck just a little bit too far in front of him. Off of his right foot, gets too much wood on it, almost double hits it.
Mike Knubel, Jeff Carter, the only two Flyers playing in their 82nd game of the season. Evgeny Malkin, also an 82-game man, along with Jordan Staal, the only two Penguins in that category. Here's a chance in front. Big stop, Fleury, rebound on the backhand. And Prospel shot that wide after getting the first chance. So the Flyers have come close, and now four Penguins through center. Pass across, and that's steered away by Marty Baron. Letang plays it back. Adam Hall on the far side with Beach. A couple of players that haven't seen much action the past few months, and that's kicked out by Baron. Scott Hartnell turns. The former Nashville Predator right through center. Fans on that pass. Nobody for Pittsburgh seemed to want it, and now Talbot will get things organized. Defers to Gonchar. His errant pass picked off by Downey. Here's Steve Downey, watched by Orpik. Lassie Kukkonen. And the puck on a high stick is called. We'll have a face-off in the Pittsburgh zone when we come back.
Kidding me?
Oh, baby.
Hey.
Keep them coming, Jay, because we may not see any here.
Yeah, exactly. Well, the Stars are doing squat, so let's take a look at some of the pluggers. Adam Hall hitting the first period. He's only played three shifts all game, but every time he gets a chance on the ice, he actually creates something. That play there, R.J. Umberger hears footsteps, and he blatantly gives it away.
Hall's second game back after missing 33, hernia surgery back in January. Jeff Carter plays it back. Kimmo Tiivanen fires. Off Fleury, and Stahl's got the rebound and heads up, plays with Hossa and Ruutu. Marian Hossa looking for his 300th goal, but the play is offside.
The Nashville Predators, Leopold decided he was going to strip the team of all its stars and place $500 over the floor. Had to deal guys like Kimmo Tiivanen, who was the best defenseman in Nashville and is the best defenseman on Philadelphia. And that little play there across the blue line, head up, toe dragging it as he brings it to a better place to shoot, but looking more for a tip and a screen than a goal.
Team, and one of the reasons the Flyers' 37-point improvement on last year, pending the outcome of today's game.
Holmgren trades for him, he's their best defenseman. Trades for Prospel at the deadline, he's their leading goal scorer. Signs Briere, who's their leading power play guy. Trades for Baron as their starting goalie. Is there any position that he traded for a player, that player became a core impact player on the Flyers.
By the way, Danny Briere being fitted for a brace. They think he will be available for the playoffs. And there's news that Darian Hatcher could be available late in round one. They're calling that miraculous as he suffered a broken leg in March. But they do expect to get Hatcher back sometime late in round one. If there is late in round one. Thorsson a chance, and he shot it high. Patrick Thorsson looking for his first goal as a Flyer. And he fired it high, and Hal Gill behind the net, getting involved again. And Steve Downey in the middle of it.
Gill has been involved all game long. Last good chance of the hockey game. Thorsson just has to adjust his trigger finger a little bit here. Good chance. This is about a 20-footer. Misses the net, but off of the glass, it nearly comes off the back of the net. Hits Fleury in the back. Last time I saw one of those was a Mark Fitzpatrick overtime goal. A Brett Hull shot. And from a goaltender standpoint, you don't get much more embarrassing than that.
Looked like that from that overhead view. It, the shot high may have glanced off the shoulder of Fleury. One of the best chances we've seen in the game. Now the Flyers with a 12-9 edge in shots. But Steve Downey draws the only penalty. And Pittsburgh gets another chance to kickstart the power play. Malkin across. Ryan Whitney to the point. Gonchar to Malkin. As they play the umbrella and send it across, Malkin, right point. Back to him again from Sikora. Now to Whitney. Back across, and they're playing on the outside here. Gonchar throws it at the net wide. Rebound to Sikora. Thorson and Richards, the penalty killers for Philadelphia. Malkin finds Ryan Whitney, and that's blocked by Tiemannin. Whitney chops it in front. Richards is there. And the former Kitchener Ranger will roll it past Malkin the length of the ice. 7 minutes left here in the second period. A minute remaining in the Downey Minor. And we're still scoreless. Gonchar with the rim that finds Jordan Staal. Malkin in support, but it's chipped pass. Here's Carter. 3-on-1 with Knubel. Mike Knubel back to Carter. What a stop! Fleury robbing Carter on the return pass from Knubel. And another shorthanded chance for the Flyers. That comes back to the point. Glenn, you got a better angle on that. Here's Letang, a shot off the screen. Was that a sensational Fleury stop, or maybe the side of the net?
Okay, well, I'm not going to say it's a sensational save, although I'd like to give Fleury all the credit. I'll give him credit because he's in a good position to make the shooter shoot it quick. He's deep in his net so he can get to this puck. Off the side of the net, but great save, Fleury, nonetheless. Give him full marks. Again, shorthanded chance. They're giving them away like Christmas gifts.
Wow. That's not a shot, but they've had five shorthanded shots in the game. And down to the final 15 seconds of this power play. Closer to Beach. Back up top. Four pick and Letang. Beach top of the circle. Hossa on the goal line in front. Roberts trying to knock it down. Puck cleared. Downey over the box. Why is it that that puck always finds the guy coming out of the penalty box? And for today, it's usually been Steve Downey. Well, he had to serve that one, bud.
Yeah, we had no choice on this one.
Here is Crosby getting it ahead. Braden Coburn moves up. We got a penalty behind the play. As Hartnell and Roberts had something going, and Hartnell's going off. Much to the displeasure of the Flyer faithful.
Scotty Hartnell takes offense to Gary Roberts. Whack on the top of the head with a stick. Watches Roberts on the back check. That whack on the top of the head. He looks back. That not a penalty? Well, Scotty, this is. And so he goes to the box. What's wrong with this? Pittsburgh power play. Wait, oh, Malone's got the answer. He's got his hand up. I know what's wrong. I know. 87's not here. Maybe if Malone keeps a stick on the ice and stop directing traffic, they might have a better chance in this PP, no?
Sixth power play of the game. Oford did not register a shot on their last man advantage. And Alex Ovechkin's got his feet up at home, celebrating his Art Ross trophy. Look at this. Another shorthanded chance. Mike Richards alone. And he stopped on a poke check by Fleury. What's that? Six chances now? Shorthanded for Philly. Pittsburgh doesn't have six chances in the game, and the Flyers don't have six even strength or on the power play. Whitney to Hossa. Back up top. There's Gonchar. Gonchar loads and fires. Just missed. Malkin's got it. Hossa and Malkin. Getting things organized in front. Malone tried the tip, but couldn't get it through. Working against Lassie Kukkonen. Now Malone after it. Whitney moves down low. Kukkonen trying to clear. Whitney's got it in the corner. There's Hossa. Malkin in front, and it skipped over his stick. Chance to clear. No, Whitney's got it. Gonchar. Hossa. 33 seconds left in this power play. There's Gonchar's shot. And that changed direction off Durand.
Philadelphia's tired, Chris.
Whitney again into the glove of Marty Baron. That's the best power play shot, but Baron has the answer.
Let's take a look at the big save here, the power play. And it wasn't that glove save. This one here, Richards for the sixth shorthanded chance. And is that a poke check by Fleury? Not really. Richards loses the puck off the stick, but Fleury's there nonetheless.
From the face-off, Knubel chips it past Letang. Off he goes and then over-skates it. Would have been offside. Lets it go, and with 10 seconds left in another feeble Penguin power play. Remember, they went 4-for-6 and scored twice with Scott Hartnell in the box Wednesday. But Hartnell's back on the ice here, and they're 0-for-6 in this game. They did get a shot. Pascal Dupuis to Sikora. Peter Sikora's shot that goes wide. Orpik holds the zone momentarily. Now it's out. And Orpik plays it to the far side, and Coburn goes back. A fine year this young defenseman's had after coming over late last year in a lopsided trade from Atlanta.
Leads the team with a plus 17. That's probably the worst trade at the deadline last season or this season. I know Atlanta got in, but it didn't take long for Zhitnik to get out.
But what
and right out of their lineup.
9 goals to boot for a kid who's starting to show his offensive prowess from the back line. Under 3 to go here in the second. And still awaiting the game's first goal. Ryan Parent lost it. And George Larocque's got it. Trying to hook up with Talbot, and that's offside at the Philadelphia line. We'll see TSN's coverage of the 2008 Masters begins Wednesday with the par 3 contest live from Augusta National Golf Club. Live coverage beginning at 3 o'clock Eastern, noon Pacific, and it's available on TSN HD.
They're on the green jacket. We go to Daniel Briere, who rewarded it today with his minus 22 season. Is this an offside play? Nope, I don't think so. Didn't really matter, though. George Larocque on the ice. Happy to have the whistle.
I'll let
get
you
a change and have Malkin come out, because Chris, he's still 6 back.
He's Ovechkin. Only a half dozen back. And 22 minutes to go.
Betting money would say he could do it.
I don't think Mr. Ovechkin's going to break a sweat worrying about it today.
Turned it off at the end of the first, I think. That's been an ugly game for both teams. Pittsburgh have been about as flat as I've seen them in a couple months.
Chance to win the Eastern Conference, but they need to win. And the Flyers will play Pittsburgh in round 1. If they lose, if they win, they get the Washington Capitals. And the aforementioned Mr. Ovechkin. Jeff Carter kicks it down. Malkin picks it up. He stopped. Forreston broke it up and shot right on rebound. And Fleury's got that too. And if you're looking for the best player on Pittsburgh today, you may not have to look any further than the Penguin goaltender.
Now, if you're not sharp, you could get hurt. Malkin turns the puck over. He doesn't see Thorson here. Yike, gets out of the way and turns the puck over. And then that leads to the real good chance. Not one, but two real good chances. That's the other element, too. If you're not on your A game, you're not fully aware of what's going on the ice, you also risk injury. Malkin had no idea that Thorson was stepping up on him. Didn't hear him, see him, or wasn't aware of it.
Face off one by the Flyers. Modry plays it in back of the net to the side of the net. Chopping at it there. Fleury down as Knubel had a couple of whacks at it. And big number 22's had the best chances for Philly.
Couple real good chances. Penguins have been dreadful on the faceoff. Just over 40%. They lose the draw, and then the puck is in their end for as long as it has to be until Fleury seals the deal with his glove.
There's the first goal of the game. Scotty Upshaw off another face-off loss by the Penguins. Glenn, you're right. They're the worst face-off team in the NHL, and it bit them here.
whole lot of stick checking going on. These guys in white look like a bunch of matadors. Face-off loss. Four white sweaters standing around. Look like sentries at Buckingham Palace. You're going to be soft in any area. Don't be soft in front of the net. Carter's smart enough to know that he goes forward with that draw. It's a shot on net, tries to catch the goalie napping. Goalie wasn't napping, but the rest were.
I'm off in 38.9% in the faceoff circle this year. Carter with the shot right from the draw on Upshaw has the icebreaker here in Philadelphia.
Now take a look at Carter's left hand. It's not at the top of the stick. Down low, as if he's going to win it backwards. And so from a goaltender standpoint, when you see that hand on the stick, you don't think there's a chance that the player would want to go forward. The catcher's everyone sleeping.
Yeah, that was Jordan Staal, and Staal at 42.2%. Malkin a shot, and Baron's got that up off the shoulder.
That 42% wouldn't even get him elected here in the United States.
Well, they are 46% as a team, Pittsburgh. Flyers are ranked 20th in the faceoff circle, so they aren't world beaters in that category either, but they do generate the first goal from a faceoff win. Now the faceoff in the Flyer zone. It was won by Richards, but he was unable to clear. Now it's flipped out. Richards unable to corral it at center. Final minute here in the second period. It's Upshaw with the goal. His 14th of the year from Knubel and Carter. Gonchar pounds it around past Timonen down the ice. No icing as Timonen goes back to retrieve it. Timo Timonen flipping it towards Scuderi. Gets rid of it for Gonchar. He'll move it around for Talbot. Less than a half minute to go. Talbot has Dupuis and Routoux a shot. Stopped by Biron. The rebound gathered by Pittsburgh. Talbot to Routoux behind the net. Penguins trying to answer before the end of the period. But it's scooped up by Richards, and he'll try and kill the last 10 seconds. With Coburn. Down with Kukkonen behind the net, but Hartnell's got it out at center. And time will run out in period number two. The goal comes late off the stick of Upshaw. And we're told there's a penalty at the end of the period to Jarkko Routoux for interference. Let's have a look.
Could have got him multiple times. This is the first time right here for interference. And then at the blue line, he does it again. So it's not bad enough that you put your team behind once. You could have done it twice.
So they got the first one, Philadelphia the lead, and a power play when we start the third. Let's join James Duthie. Thank you, James. A short list of players who have stood out today, Glenn, but you found one.
Yeah, Scotty Upshaw's been great. He's a healthy scratch on Wednesday, and he has come to compete. This is the battle in the first period. This is the battle at the end of the first period. No backing down, and when you do the right things, and you get into the trenches in the ugly areas, then you get awarded a gift. Hossa lets you go, and you can tap in a birdie putt. So Upshaw's been great. Coach's decision not to play him, and he has responded tonight.
Well, no power in that power play tonight. They have given up five shots and five great Flyer shorthanded scoring chances. And we talked about the importance of face-offs. It led to the one goal, and Jim Dowd, the 39-year-old vet, has been terrific in the face-off circle for Philadelphia. Jarkko Routoux drew the penalty at the 20-minute mark of the second period. So the Flyers will start the third with the man advantage. And they have Upshaw up front with Knubel and Carter. Timonen and Richards, the fourth forward, on this Flyer power play. And here is the Flyer MVP back to Timonen.
Will
rim it. They had to wait. Somebody was inside the line and they still haven't tagged up properly. And Jeff Carter leaves the zone. Timonen brings it back in. Love down, and Marc-Andre Fleury will hold on. There was a suggestion we might see Ty Conklin in relief in this game, but with a one-goal game, Conklin continues to watch, and Fleury continues to shine.
Well, Fleury's your guy, and if this is to be a first-round matchup, you want him creating some headworms between the ears of the Philadelphia Flyers. They can't beat him. That he is too good.
This, by the way, is not an accurate showcase of what a Philadelphia-Pittsburgh series might look like.
TSN was to draw this as the matchup, and these are the way the games will go. Chris, I'm out.
I just don't think it's going to look like this come Wednesday or Thursday. Shot deflected wide. Hartnell was parked in front. Or picked to Dupuis and down the ice. But right now, it would be Pittsburgh and Ottawa in the opening round. Ottawa with two wins, 2-1-1 against Pittsburgh during the regular season. Philadelphia would draw Washington if the game continues in Philadelphia's favor. Here's Upshaw dancing back in. Got a work pass at area, unable to do so. Jordan Staal, who had 7 shorthanded goals last year without one this season. There's a shot. Fleury had trouble with that rebound and had to make a big stop. Let a rebound get away and gave up a scoring chance because of it. Ruutu gets set to return. And he's back out there now. That shot knocked down on Root. Staal gives it away. Carter turns back. Jeff Carter looking for Knubel. Lost it in the corner. Thorsson to Carter. A shot. Missed short side. And Ruutu will roll it down the ice and head to the bench. And there's going to be a penalty against Pittsburgh. Flyers will get another power play here. Knubel inside the line. Letang touches the puck. And play is stopped. Well, closed captioning of the NHL on TSN is brought to you by the 2008 Kia Rondo, Canada's urban utility vehicle. From Kia, the power to surprise.
Now, you're not going to fool Bill McCreary. He saw Ruutu and read his mind and watched the action. Ruutu pretending he's just getting rid of the puck, and he gets his elbow up and then makes his way to the bench to try to find a hiding spot. No place to hide.
Power plays haven't been dangerous for either team so far today. Let's see if that changes. Richard shot ramps up off the stick of Brooks Orpik onto the screen.
You take penalties in games, and some of them are necessary, but if the game doesn't mean much to Pittsburgh and they want to play Ottawa, then knock yourself out. But what you don't want to have now is guys having to block shots because Ruutu's not playing smart. And that's what could happen. One shot off the ankle of a Gonchar or a Malkin or any other skilled player. That's terrible news.
Timo Timonen playing it back to Marty Baron in his own zone. Pascal Dupuis out in a penalty-killing capacity with Max Talbot. And here's Vinny Prospel.
No!
He'll dump it in. Hartnell in pursuit. Gonchar gave it away. And gets it to Orpik. Prospel hounds him. Dupuis clears. The high-powered Pittsburgh Penguins with 12 shots on goal here early in the third period. And now on their heels, trying to kill another Philadelphia penalty. Hartnell behind the net. Knocked past Prospel by Scuderi. Staal off the boards, gloved down by Richards. Looking for Hartnell. Up against Gill, who goes down on the play. Lupul to the point. Timonen returns it. Here's Joffrey Lupul, a shot off a leg. Wide of the net. Rob Scuderi off the boards, but held in by Timo Timonen. Lupul along the wall. Remember a few years back in Anaheim, a 9-goal playoff for Joffrey Lupul. Scuderi shovels it, but Richards awaits. Trying to center Prospel in front, and Hartnell just batted it wide. Close call, another, but it bounced off over the stick of Hartnell, poised at the top of the crease. Now Lupul. Back to Richards. Returns to Lupul. Mike Richards. Lupul. In low, Prospel. Lupul takes the shot. Loose in front. Lupul again centers. And Ruutu out of the box. And Ruutu after the puck. He's got it from the box to the attack. And it was poked away by Biron. So playing a recurring theme today. Every time a guy comes out of the penalty box, he manages to find the puck.
Like glue.
Playing right into your theory.
You don't have many of them.
And not many of them are very good, but this one seems to have legs.
Thank you, sir.
Upshaw blocked, but he gets it back again. Into the slot, Carter, and I think that hit the skate of Knubel.
Well, no matter how bad my theories are, they certainly aren't as bad as yours, Tinkerbell.
Yes.
Thinking that Malkin was going to get 6 points today.
He's back on the ice.
The Pittsburgh Penguins have had three scoring chances.
Yeah.
I'm not even concerned about the shots. Three scoring chances. That's the troubling one.
No, and I don't think Malkin's been in the middle of any of them.
Flyer fans have gotten out of their seat once, but they haven't got to the edge of their seat once for Pittsburgh.
Here's Big 71 trying to center it. Cleared away. Letang across. Gonchar, penalty coming up against Philadelphia. As Gonchar weaves his way in. Malkin back to Gonchar. Centers. Chance and a shot wide. Talbot came off the bench. Had the chance. And now the puck is touched. Penalty upcoming against Philadelphia. And we've got an update from Jay Onright. Lassie Kukkonen in the penalty box, and we'll get Pittsburgh back on the power play for the seventh time of the game. Again, the third-ranked power play in the league, but just nothing happening so far today.
They've been exciting, though. They've done nothing but give Philadelphia chances on the power play.
Now, I shouldn't say nothing's happened, because a lot's happened for Philly on these Pittsburgh power plays. Gary Roberts and Chris Peach getting another turn with Pascal Dupuis. So that threesome will tell you all you need to know about Pittsburgh's power play tonight. And away goes Richards. A couple of Penguins back, however, and a good defensive play by Gonchar. Ryan Whitney back to the attack. Wide on Jones. Whitney loses it, and Jones will clear it. 50 seconds gone. And another Pittsburgh power play that hasn't put any fear in Philadelphia so far in this game. 7 minutes into the third. Malkin lost it outside the line. Checked by Dowd. R.J. Umberger, long range shot high. Marian Hossa lost it. Jim Dowd into the slot. Shot, and Jones ripped it wide. Marian Hossa looks like he's looking for Sidney Crosby, wondering where he is here in this game. Got it to Malone. And now a chance to clear, held in by Letang. Modry battling against Malkin. Gonchar, right point. Chris Letang, tracked by Carter. Spots Malkin, a cross-ice pass, broken up by Modry, and dumped out by Knubel. Hossa back in. Bouncing pucker, Malone might have had a lane to the net. Malkin tries to center, unable to do so. And the Flyers back at full strength. And another no-shot power play for the Pittsburgh Penguins. 0 for 7 in the game. Here's Malkin. Centered. That one. Unable to be corralled by Malkin. Malone's got it. Back to 71. A shot. Stop. Rebound. And up with it is R.J. Umberger. And out. And he'll chop it down. Check that that was Lassie Kukkonen with the play. That gets Philadelphia change. Approaching 9 minutes of the third period. Chance in front. Here's Crosby off the side of the net. And 14 shots for Pittsburgh in 49 minutes. Upshaw, Ryan Parrott fires, and a pad stop there by Marc-Andre Fleury. Crossbill off the wall. Hartnell side of the net, up against Gill. Crossbill helps up. Billy Crossbill to Parrott, handcuffs him. Foot raise, a look at Marty Baron scamper out. Couldn't get it out. And as he retreated, made a save. Another calling a hand pass, and play is stopped. 10:33 left here in the third. Glenn Pittsburgh, fifth time, 100 points. Here's what happened when they set their team record for points of the year in the postseason.
Back to the point. Grant Jennings in front. Great stop, Healy. And here's Lemieux. Out in front, and he's poke checked, has it again. Backhand. Big stop, Healy. Here's Yager with Tippett. Shot, glove stop, Glenn Healy. Here they come, two on one. Bullock shoots, scores! David Bullock, Islander.
It was easy, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Come on. They had 119 points.
Yes, they did.
They finished the year with a 10-game win streak. They started the year with a 16-er. They had, believe it or not, they had Naslin on the fourth line. That's how good a team they were. And the ragtag group from the aisle beat them. I don't know how we did it. Give Al Arbor all full credit. And a goal by David Bullock, but what a series.
So beyond the gratuitous plug for your play a million years ago, just a little lesson before the playoffs start that anything can happen. Those were the two-time defending Stanley Cup champions. And a guy by the name of Healy helped beat them in seven.
They really could have been.
Here's Talbot and an easy glove stop by Biron.
They really could have been a dynasty. And because they really dismantled that team after that season. They had so much disappointment by their second round loss. They had so many great players. Yager. They had Lemieux. They had Stevens on the top line. Francis was their second line center. You can't get much better than that. Marty Straka was on their fourth line. It was a real deep, awesome team.
They had to retool to find a way to beat a goaltender who was playing for a new contract, and I believe you got one because of that, didn't you?
I got a new contract and my pink slip. I ended up with the New York Rangers. And was looked upon by all the Islanders fans as a traitor from that moment on.
Didn't take long for you to win your cup, though. 2 years later. 1 year later.
1 year later, yeah.
1 year later. 9:15 left. Is Pittsburgh going to squander this opportunity to win the Eastern Conference? Bypass Philadelphia and end up with Ottawa in round one.
Well, the good thing about the game, Chris, it won't be replayed on TSN Classics.
No danger of that. And it will not be referenced tomorrow, setting up the postseason either. 8:53 left. Thank you, Jay. And a reminder that today's game story is brought to you by Molson Canadian, the true taste of the game.
Scotty Upshaw, healthy scratch Wednesday. He got the game winner right now as it looks 0-for-7 on the power play for Pittsburgh. Absolutely dreadful. And Marty Baron with 15 saves. He stopped them all. And I don't think he's going to get an easier game ever against the Pittsburgh Penguins than he's had this afternoon.
Under 9 minutes remaining. Scotty Upshaw's goal standing up so far. Off the glass and Malkin to the attack. He's got a man open left side. Ryan Malone to the net. Chopping at it there was Hossa. Penalty coming up. Fleury goes to the bench for the extra attacker. Gonchar's got it. Scuderi back to Gonchar. Hossa. Malkin. The extra attacker is Sikora with Malone causing some traffic in front of the net. Gonchar watched by Thorsson, gets it deep. Hossa tries to center into the skates of the defender, and play is stopped as Coburn touched it. And who's got it? Looks like Kimmo Timonen heading off.
Real good pass to Malone. Now, he knows it's a one-on-one, and he really has no chance at a good shot, so he takes the puck inside. By taking it inside and using his strength and his size, doesn't get a scoring chance, doesn't even get a shot, but he draws a penalty. And that's good news for Pittsburgh on most nights. Not this afternoon, but most nights as their power play gets a chance to go to work.
And the Penguins have called a timeout to address what has been a dreadful 0-for-7 night with or game with the man advantage. Stay tuned to TSN immediately following the game from Olson That's Hockey. Host Gino Retta looks forward to the playoffs, providing opinion and analysis to today's biggest news stories and events as we sort out the playoff matchups. And this power play will get the attention of the folks watching, cheering for the Ottawa Senators and the Washington Capitals.
No matter how dreadful Pittsburgh has been this afternoon for 52 minutes, they have a good chance now to tie the hockey game. Malkin will take the draw, and then he will find himself back at the point.
So no Beach, no Gary Roberts on this power play. Let's see what they can do with the man advantage. They lose the faceoff, but Kukkonen unable to clear and hit the linesman. And he is in difficulty. I believe that's Brian Murphy that's been shaken up. It is indeed.
Do you want to be a linesman? Maybe you should have been a goalie. Right off the ankle. Side of the knee, actually. And that hurts. So we'll rewind again, Chris. Malkin will take the draw, and then he'll find his way back to the point. Pittsburgh's just got to simplify. Get the puck back to the point. Malkin's got a bomb from there, and let him shoot it.
Well, first things first, they got the draw. Gontcharov threw it at the net. It ricocheted off a flyer. Philadelphia to the attack with Jeff Carter. Carter and Knubel, the penalty killers, fool the Flyers. Carter behind the net, stripped of the puck by Ryan Malone. Here comes Peter Sikora. He'll flip it in. Sikora hasn't had much ice time today with Malkin, but out together on this power play. But Carter away. He's got Knubel. It's another 2-on-1. Carter in, and it's blocked by Gontcharov. Nicely defended by Sergei Gontcharov. Another odd man rush. Shorthanded for Philadelphia. Make it a half dozen in the game. Sikora, Hossa. Minute gone on the power play. Sikora off the wall. Gontcharov the shot, and he whipped it off target. Hossa back to Gontcharov to reload. There's Malkin. Slap pass across. Sikora, and he missed the target with Biron a little out of position coming across. There's Malone working the corner. Support from Sikora. Malone trying to swivel away from Coburn. Won't let him get away. Hossa up top. Loads and fires. Malkin quickly back up top again. Return pass from Gontcharov. Cross ice and a stick in the lane to break up the pass for Sikora, who gets it back. Malkin trying to get it to the point. Hossa, Sikora, shot, and a glove stop by Biron. With 7 seconds left in the Penguin power play.
Pittsburgh, if you have to play game 7 on the road somewhere in this series, think back to the effort level that you put in this afternoon. You're playing a point on the power play, you let a guy go by you like you're a matador, and then you don't work to get back. And then the last chance of a hockey game is a relatively easy save. Malkin, standing still basically, shoots it in the glove of Biron.
Robert Beach and Stahl on the ice as Kimmo Tiivanen returns a backhand. Stopped by Biron, rebound collected by the player returning from the box, Tiivanen. And now the Flyers will work it ahead just out of the reach of Tiivanen. And Ryan Whitney back to get it for Pittsburgh. Under 6 minutes to go here in the third period. Scotty Upshaw, the lone goal scorer in the game at 18:30 of the second period. Chris Letang moves up. to the side of the net. Roberts back to Letang at the point. Stahl after it. Bumping Jones. And Lupul swings it down ice. This is going to be icing against Philadelphia. 5:10 on the clock. 1-0 Flyers. It's the NHL on TSN. Well, Piper, a number of choices for you today.
We've heard of this guy. Name on the back says it all. Hossa, he can score. No Crosby today. And they need a game breaker. They need a difference maker. And he has not been a game breaker or a difference maker, except on one particular play. And that's the reason that he is a minus one. There he is on the right of your screen. And I should give him the mic and get him to describe it, because he watched the whole thing without taking a stride. His man Upshaw is the difference. So not today's Nessie goes to a guy who's not been a Nessie very often in his career.
No, not at all. Was in quest for his 300th NHL goal this game. Not giving you the version of Marian Hossa that was the headline story of the trade deadline day.
Go get it. 4 minutes and 40 seconds to get it.
Malkin dump, but no call. And 4.5 minutes to go as Malone tried to jam it in. Upshaw can't clear. Checked by Gonchar. Knubel kept in by Orpik. A shot and off the stick of Biron. Well, the NHL on TSN is brought to you by Molson Canadian, the true taste of the game. And we mentioned it a few times this afternoon, we have not had the true taste of playoff action here today. But that will all change Wednesday night, to be sure.
And even the crowd will change. They were as loud as they've ever been on Wednesday, and they're very quiet today here in Philadelphia. So even the crowd has decided to take the afternoon off. And there's a great sea of orange here. A lot of fans wearing black and orange in the Philadelphia Flyers. When playoffs start in this building, it is absolutely incredible to see the teams and their crowds join together with the same cause.
Yeah, the fans made a big difference Friday night in the 3-0 win over New Jersey. Flyers dominated that game from the opening faceoff, and it was bedlam here at the Wachovia Center as Philadelphia nailed down the playoff spot. Here's Sikora. Quick backhand that sailed high. Whitney off the bench. Knocked down.
Chris, I always remember my first playoff game against Calgary and walking down that long walk from the dressing room through the tunnel and walking out to the sea of red. Not ever expecting it, anticipating it, and then making that same walk at the end of the first period when it was 5-0 Calgary. It was a lot of fun. That's why home ice is important.
See, I could have used that footage today to, you know, reminisce.
It's been burnt. I've acquired all the copies. Good luck.
Randy Jones just gets rid of it. Less than 3 minutes to go now. Still 1-0. The Montreal Canadiens are that close to winning the Eastern Conference Championship. Pascal Dupuis given away, and Richard starts back. Mike Richards through center, gathering speed. Dumping it off, Knubel, bad angle shot, and Fleury's got that. Teaming it at the right point, will send it in, and Flyers changing behind him. Knubel, the lone man, forechecking. And here's Malone. Teaming in there. Malone stays on it. Unless the Penguins can hit the score sheet, Montreal will be number one. Pittsburgh 2. Philadelphia will be the sixth seed. Malkin twists and turns. Plays it across for Gonchar. Sends it to the net. And Biron's got that too.
What you're fighting for now, number 43. It's all about your goaltender. You work hard through 58 plus minutes to get to this point. I'm not going to use the S word, but the guys are clearing people out in front of the net. Carter does a real good job on Malone. And Pittsburgh's burnt their timeout.
And penalties offsetting to Malkin and Coburn with exactly 2 minutes to go.
It is tough. Pittsburgh has not had a good night afternoon. 58 minutes of lifeless hockey, and now it's hard to get it going. You can't just turn a switch and all of a sudden your star players are going to figure a way out of the mess they've created for themselves, even though they are just one shot away.
We're told that Minnesota and Colorado are going to overtime. That will set that matchup, and it will be Calgary, San Jose in a Western Conference first rounder.
Calgary likes that matchup.
I don't think anybody would like that one. Gonchara shot, 4-on-4. Stahl and Sikora up against Umberger. And now Philadelphia making a change, so Richards comes back with Leupel for the Flyers. Letang working ahead. Stahl took it away from Sikora to hit in himself. Broken up by Randy Jones. Hooking to Coburn, a diving call to Malkin with the offsetting penalties. Less than 80 seconds remaining as Leupel flips it in, and it will be gloved down by Fleury.
Malkin may be the only guy you want on the ice.
Not necessarily the way things have gone today, but off the glove and onto the screen.
It's been a decent afternoon for Philadelphia. They have limited the Pittsburgh Penguins, which are a pretty explosive powerhouse, to less than 5 scoring chances in our count, and that's exceptional. And they're going to put another win on the board and finish as high up as they possibly could.
Well, they have pulled the goaltender. The extra attacker comes on. 5 skaters against 4. And Whitney's shot doesn't get through. Open net. Jeff Carter misses. In quest for 30, Mike Knuble stops, scores on the rebound. And you can book the playoff matchup to the East now.
Turnover at the blue line causes it. Pittsburgh's going to complain that Carter's playing with a broken stick. Now they can complain all they want, whatever. There's the missed chance. There's Knuble. You see Carter's stick in his hand. It's broken as he had skated from the hash marks behind the net with it. But does it really matter? And that's what Sikora is complaining about to the referee. Carter down the ice. And with this shot here, the stick is broken. Doesn't drop it. And the goal counts. Not a reviewable situation anyway. So the referees might have missed a little one. End of the day, that Pittsburgh doesn't deserve the call.
29th for Knuble, who had a couple of chances earlier in the game. Carter missing the open net for his try at 30. So barring a last-minute miracle here by Pittsburgh, they will be the second seed.
And are you now willing to confirm that Malkin, sitting in the box,
I believe,
will not get 6 points today?
The decision desk has ruled that Alex Ovechkin is the scoring champion for the 2007-2008 series season.
You can turn away from the game, Alex. You've got it in the bank.
Washington against Philadelphia. It's going to be the Ottawa Senators against the Pittsburgh Penguins in round one. As Marty Biron tunes up for his first ever Stanley Cup playoff start with a shutout here against the Penguins. Well, it was not the most inspired effort, but the Flyers got what they needed to avoid Pittsburgh, and the Penguins don't win the East. 2-0 the final. That's Hockey with Gino Retta is next.
The insiders in the studio.
Give me an insider. Yeah.